There's pulleys on this thing. Whoa. This is professional gear. So tell us what this is for.
Well, being in a cage, something like this, especially with a blindfold, you may be restrained. You know, you're losing some of your senses. You kind of let yourself go over to whatever may happen. So there's access on the front. If we wanted to open this up and say, open up his pants, you know, you have cock access. Or if you wanted to turn him around and have butt access, there's, you know, a special little spot for getting right into there as well. But being in a cage is definitely a mindset. You know, you don't know what's happening or who's touching you or what. And so you just, your mind is somewhere else.
Again, you have to try it to really understand it and appreciate it. So we'll be back, Philippe.
Okay.
Ropes.
In ice, you know, in the cage and whatnot is different hoods. This is one of the favorite. It's very, very intimidating, but you basically take the eyes, the ears, the mouth, everything away. They can't hear, they can't see. You give them water when you think they need water and that sort of thing. Let's say you're in a close relationship, you've been married for 20 years. Something like this might be a little intense, but if you use something like this and take away the person's eyes, the mouth, the nose, it really depersonalizes them, and you're able to spank them, you're able to hit them, you're able to inflict the pain / pleasure that you might not normally would had they not had the hood or mask on.
Is there a scientific explanation why this is so much fun?
You get turned on. It just feels good.
I think it's something very simple. Our nervous system is designed to recognize things that are different. So if you've been married for, what, like 10 years, and you want to try something different, this is definitely different.
And a lot of fun.
This is not duct tape. What is this for?
Well, that is bondage tape. So that will stick to itself and not to your skin or your hair. So it's very safe. You can use it as a gag, a blindfold, around your wrist, ankles, and just cut it off when you're done.
It sounds very useful. And tell us about dog play.
Puppy play, yes. You know what puppies are, right? Well, it's kind of like pony play, but puppies. So people put on a hood in a different style, different character. And then they have different paws. They'll insert a tail, and they'll literally act like a dog. They'll insert the puppy tail up their butt when using a butt plug, and maybe they'll hold that in with a harness of some sort. And then they'll pretend they're a puppy. They'll sit at their master's feet. They'll rummage through old dirty clothes looking for a sock or something, and just lavish in the life of a puppy, not having any worries, any cares, and then being told what to do, where to sit, where your food is, taken out for a walk. They're led around on leashes. And there's various groups here actually in the city that hold puppy play parties, different groups. One here, actually, you can go to Mr. S website and find out one of those as well.
Wow, so the people that do this kind of thing, is it really a cross-section? Is it mostly straight couples, gay couples, single people?
Well, with puppy play, it's pretty much a gay crowd. If you're looking at pony play, that's a little bit more straight or bi. Now, pony play, just like puppy play, they'll have a ponytail made with real horse hair. Or they'll put a bit in their mouth, like a horse would, and be led around, lead a carriage down the street during Folsom, that type of thing.
So, Pristine, I'm amazed at how much you know about this. I was just wondering, you live in a world of drag. You have your own life when you're just being Rob. And then it looks like you're involved with this community as well. Are you going in and out of these different worlds?
That's what I love about this city, that I can go in and out of this world. I've been working here for Mr. S for 2 years, been involved in the leather community for years before that. It's just a fun cross-section of people here in the city that allow you to be creative and, you know, get your kink on.
Are you excited for me? Behind the scenes. Hope you're not trying to get a job in San Francisco or anywhere on the internet, for that matter.
I might get a job in San Francisco because I did this.
Yeah, you're right.
Exactly.
If you think your boss is bad, just look what my boss made me do.
Oh, there's ponies on this thing. Whoa. This is...
professional gear.